Gaya.
October 12, 2015, by Trevin O'Hare.
Clouds, shape-shifting.
In both subtle and dramatic ways, you can shape-shift through your choice of appearance, attitudes, and ability to understand. When you meet a new person, many of you probably can understand what I mean when I say this. Because of the thousands of lives you lived before, you can almost always read a person's personality within just a few minutes of meeting them. You are able to categorize a vast array of personalities, and through this openness and vigilance, you are able to focus on topics that you can relate with just about anyone you meet, which makes you a very likable person. You may have noticed throughout your life that people you barely know are usually comfortable around you and they can't even figure out why. But many of them will start to vent and share their personal lives with you, because they can sense the goodness and healing potential of your soul. Many are healed just from spending a short time in conversation with you. Some of you more social people may have noticed that generally most people you meet find you to be a likable and engaging person. They see your energy of light, your energy of love and compassion, and these traits tend to draw a lot of people to you. You can almost get along with anyone and rarely are involved in any sorts of drama, and are not very interested in the third-dimensional problems, obsessions, and the materialistic matrix this planet has been engulfed in. When you are anything but your true self, you may see attitudes of people towards you change. But when you are living and expressing your truest of self, many people are drawn to that characteristic of you. You and only you have the power that people see what you want them to see. You have an uncanny ability to be able to relate to just about anyone. Because we all are one. And every person is an extension of our souls as well. And you can truly feel the empathy for so many. You feel their pain and you are unknowingly drawn to helping these people like the true healer you really are. With just a little focus and quiet, you can sit and think of anyone you wish to send healing light into their lives, and generally within a short time, you see these people improving drastically. Do not underestimate the true power of your soul and its healing knowledge and abilities. When someone hurts you, love them. When someone is against you, love them. Allow these people to follow their own soul's paths, and you just keep content and humble no matter the situation. Everybody has pain and secrets, and this is what creates the hatred or negativity in a person. They are not bad people, just lost souls, and they will find the light one day as well. But must do it all in their very own ways. When you focus in on a deep energy that radiated from your heart, your aura expands and has the healing energy that can engulf others around you. You are a conduit. Your empathy is their feelings flowing into you, because you can absorb all their pain and release it all in a proper way. Because many don't know how to release, so that is why you are the conduit of light. You absorb and are able to release it all back into the universe and beyond, leaving these people with a warm feeling in their heart and ready to continue on their path of evolution. You are the channel that removes the debris blocking these people's paths. This is my short message for you, dear ones. The vibrational frequencies of your consciousness have been sped up so drastically that you can change vibrations of anything and anyone around you. But this gift is very powerful and does come with some challenges. Being that you can manifest and change the reality around you and others, you can also send very bad things to others without knowing you are. So in any anger or resentment you feel, do not focus it on anyone, because what you send out, comes back to you tenfold. Breathe when someone angers you and diffuse or completely avoid the situation or conflict altogether. Your power is strong, my loved creations. And you are returning to your God consciousness within. Use this knowledge and power for good, and you don't know how much of an effect your thoughts, focus and actions can truly make in so many people's lives. You are one of humanity's lighthouses, the candle in the dark, drawing all those to you and into your unconditional healing light. The best way to be in control and have these energies empowered and much stronger. First, you should focus on clearing your own energy and blockages within your chakra systems. So here I have some prayers to help you and others along your journeys. These prayers all represent one of your seven main energy chakras. Use them and allow them to clear any blockages or pain still lingering in your light body and energy vortexes. For the root chakra, Focus on a beautiful swirling red light emanating from the base of your spine and repeat.
I am vibrant and vital, aroused with life force. I am passionately physical and a potent animal. My strength grounds me. I will survive.
In the sacral chakra, now imagine it to be a swirling orange light within, and speak.
I am protected from anxiety, immune from negativity. My sense of well-being radiates life energy. I give and I receive. I am the transformer.
Now move up into your solar plexus, and imagine the light to be yellow now and say.
I am fulfilled emotionally, for spiritual wisdom is my gift. My place in the universe is clear and focused. I accept my power.
Now into the green light of the heart chakra, visualize the green vortex and say.
I soothe and comfort you, because I am a healer. Relax now into the balance. We are all connected naturally with grace. I grow through compassion.
Now to the throat, which is a swirling vortex of a deep blue light in the center of truth. Now speak.
I assimilate, I communicate, my ideas flow peacefully. Expressing the self, listening, speaking, the information is inspired. I reveal my true feelings.
And to the third eye, located in the middle of your forehead between your eyes. The chakra of sight and the ability to see through illusions. Imagine it swirling with a radiant indigo flame and say.
I see your beauty, and your spiritual light, my feelings of love fill me with insight, and heal my pain. I'm open to my intuitions.
Now the last chakra that is the most powerful energy to connect with the divine and your higher selves. Located at the top of your head. Imagine a large violet flame burning and swirling above your head. Fully opening the energy body and allowing the violet flame to engulf your entire body and speak.
Faith and knowingness, right me with the eternal universe. With dignity I am crowned. The divine is within.
I would like to add, that plants I have created for you can be a very powerful tool of cleansing. Burning sage, cedar wood, and several other types of plants are a very effective way of removing negativity from a person, object or space. Allow the smoke to fill the air and open a window so that the negativity can flow out of the space. When you burn these plants, the negative energies attach to the smoke and sent out of the space as the smoke flows outside. I love you all and hope you can successfully use these techniques I have shared. Love, your Mother Gaia. Namaste.